This video is sponsored by DFRobot. Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous video, glad to see you back. I assume that you've just finished project number 13. If so, let's move on to project number 14 or IR remote controlled LED. This time, we would use an IR receiver partnered with an IR remote control to turn an LED on or off to demonstrate the basics of controlling things by using infrared signals. Let's go! Here are the things that we're going to need for this project: the DF Arduino board, prototyping shield, mill-to-mill jumper cables, mini IR remote control, and of course, an IR receiver. Now, these items are just for the warm-up project. For the final project, we would also need a 220 ohm resistor and an LED. Moving on to the wiring phase, again, this is just the warm-up project. We would add a few more components later on, so stay tuned for that. Alright, let's start by getting our DF Arduino board, mount the prototyping shield on top of it, get our IR receiver. So this pin right here is the 5V pin, middle one is ground, and this other one is the data or digital out. We should connect it like this. See this bump right here? This should be facing us because this is where the receiver is located. Now let's connect its right leg to the 5V supply, middle leg to ground, and its left leg to DF Arduino's digital pin number 11. That's all for now. Next, let's get our IR remote ready. Make sure to remove this plastic thingy right here. This was added to prevent the battery from touching the other terminal to prolong its lifespan during storage and shipping. Alright, now let's put the battery back. Let's connect our board to the computer. Here is the sample code that DFRobot has provided. This is actually one of the sample codes from the IR remote library called IR Receive Demo. You can download and install it using the Arduino IDE or GitHub. If you went for the GitHub route, you can also download the sample codes pack from DFRobot there. But my advice is to just download and install the IR remote library directly from the dev's repo, because the one from DFRobot's repository is really outdated and it doesn't work anymore. Okay, so let's just paste the code from the PDF to the Arduino IDE. Click on verify. Whoops! Forgot to comment this. Let's try it again. Click on verify. Forgot to comment this one too. Click on verify again. Forgot to add a comment on these ones too. Alright, let's click on upload. Launch the serial monitor. Let's see if this would work. There we go. See that? The serial monitor displays each button's respective hex code on every press. It would also only decode hex codes if the library is familiar with a certain remote that is being used. Now, let's see what would happen if I press and hold this button. Here's how the code works. First, we call the IR remote library. Int receive pin equals 11 is where the IR receiver is connected, which is on DF Arduino's digital pin number 11. IR receive, receive pin. Add the IR receive data type from the IR remote library and make it use the receive pin variable to set it as the dedicated IR receiver port or pin. This line of code uses the decode results data type from the IR remote library and saves what the IR receiver is reading or receiving by using the results variable. Onto the void setup, we use serial begin to enable the serial monitor and use 9600 as its baud rate. Next, we have an IR remote library function called enable IR in. This is used to kickstart the IR receiver by enabling the IR receive variable that uses the receive pin variable, which represents DF Arduino's digital pin number 11. Moving on to the void loop, we have an if statement. This block of code is set to first, save the decoded hex values from the remote control to the variable called results by using the .decode function from the IR remote library. Print the hex values to the serial monitor by using serial.println. Then, wait for the next signal from the remote control after printing. And that's it for the warm-up project. So, as I have mentioned earlier, for the final project, we'd have to add an LED and a 220 ohm resistor. Okay, let's attach the LED right here while keeping in mind where the LED's anode is located. Connect the resistor to the LED's anode like so. Let's get some hookup wires. Connect this one to the other leg of the resistor. Then connect it to DF Arduino's digital pin number 12. Connect another hookup wire, this time to the LED's cathode, then to DF Arduino's ground. Now here's the sample code for the final project. Not gonna lie, it does look quite similar to the warm-up project's code. As you can see here, if we remove these commented lines, the only difference of the final project's code are these few lines. Int LED pin, boolean, pin mode, and an if statement. Okay, let's just copy the code from the PDF. Make sure that our MCU is being detected and we're on the correct port. Click on verify. Oh, comment that. Click on verify. Then upload the code. Okay, so if the results value is equal to 0xfd00ff, the LED should turn on. Let's launch the serial monitor. There we go. Here's how the final code works. Okay, so basically it works pretty much just like on the warm-up project. But this time we've added a few more lines of code. We have added int LED pin equals 10, which is DF Arduino's digital pin number 10 and is where the LED is connected. We have added boolean LED state equals low to set the LED's initial status to low using the LED state variable, which should also be used to store the LED's state. We have added pin mode LED pin output to the void setup to set the LED pin's variable as an output. And lastly, we've added another if statement. This block of code means that if the certain value, of hex code was received by the IR receiver from the remote control, LED state is equal to not LED state. It would reverse the state of the current state of the LED state. For example, if the LED is currently turned on, that would mean boolean LED state equals high. Once the certain hex code of FD00FF was received by the IR receiver, it would reverse the status of the LED state. If it's high or turned on, it would turn to low or off and vice versa. It is possible to do because we used LED state for the digital write function's value. You see, digital write has two parameters, pin numbers, or in this case, the variable LED pin, which represents DF Arduino's digital pin number 10, and value, the value being high or low or on or off. And that's all there is to it, really. I know that it can be quite confusing, so for a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!